You're watching a segment of The Splash, Greater West Bloomfield's news magazine show.
Move over, drinking at home in a dark, dank, thankless concrete room, and say hello to drinking out on the range. Bowers Farm was hopping with hops last weekend as I attended their fundraiser for adults only, the Bourbon and Brews Festival. I sat down with Alan Jaros, director of Bowers Farm and the Johnson Nature Center, to talk about how they intend to use the funds raised, as well as their role in the community.
The farm here is owned by the Bloomfield Hills Schools, and we serve anywhere from 40 to 50,000 visitors a year. Most of those are in our school programs. That's our mission-focused work. And so when we can branch out from that and bring adults onto the property for an evening fun, it sort of changes the feel, the vibe on the farm. Mm-hmm. Our mission is that we are open to all, regardless. So we hope to expand our field trip program regionally.
Not only do they plan to enhance their field trip program, but also enhance the in-person agricultural studies the children partake in almost daily.
In our blood, every one of us, we have agrarian roots. They're somewhere there, right? We grew food. And being that we, times are different, we still crave that connection. And you see it when people get here, they light up. For example, during camp, every day those kids are in the garden, they harvest produce, they take it back, and they cook with it in the kitchen. Talk about life skills, right? Those are things that we don't do in the classroom anymore. And in the context of the farm, all the way to the table, it's real here. It's authentic. And so, we're proud, and the team is really proud that we're able to bring those experiences to young people and to adults. Maybe a little different tonight with the 200 different bourbon whiskeys, but hey, those are agricultural products as well.
And what an amazing product it is. I sampled plenty of beverages, and it's easy to say there wasn't a single sour sip amongst all the alcohol I sampled.
Yeah.
Except for stouts. I'm not a fan of stouts.
Yeah, no, the event is going swimmingly. people are very happy. We just about sold out tickets, and next year, I expect we'll do it again. I think the takeaway here is, there are a number of farms in the area, and what we pride ourselves on here is that everything has a purpose. All 93 acres here has a reason that it exists. So our goats give us milk. Our horses are here to ride. Our pigs, well, you can buy bratwurst in the farm store. But what we hope to show you and what we highlight and what we're open about is the fact that the animals are raised sustainably. The produce we grow, 3 acres vegetable production, is in a sustainable manner. And so when you know how your food is grown, you make food choices that are healthier for the planet, healthier for people, and healthier for the people that grow your food for you. And so where else do you get to have that experience? So I invite people to come to the farm and check it out for themselves and shop in our store and have a great time with their family, wagon ride, donuts. Yeah, and I appreciate this event and events like this that allows us to do that mission work.
With great music, good weather, and gallons upon gallons of booze to guzzle, the Bourbon and Brews event at Bowers Farm is one you should check the almanac for next year. With the success of this year's event, Last Call is nowhere in sight. Reporting for The Splash, I'm Calvin Brown.
Thanks for watching this segment of The Splash. To watch the entire show or other segments, catch us on Comcast Channel 15 and AT&T Channel 99. Or look us up online at thesplash.tv and listen to us every week on 89.3 WBLD, the all-new Lakes FM.